بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. Have you left your exam preparation too late? No need to worry. Three killer tips, inshallah, that are going to help you not only succeed in this test, not only succeed in this exam, but beyond as well, inshallah. Number one, fix up, get a timetable. Number two, reduce social media. And number three, bring in an element of spirituality. What exactly do we mean by making a timetable? Look, as Muslims, we wake up and start praying Salah, Salatul Fajr. This is the excellent time to map out your day from until the time you go to bed. When you wake up in the morning, pray Fajr Salah, spend a little bit of time afterwards, and then after that, sit and resume and start your preparation, your revision and your exam preparation from then. Have intervals of study. Don't be a study zombie where you just open up your books and go wild. You're not going to get anywhere. Keep in mind the 80-20 rule that you will get 80% of your results from only 20% of your efforts. So break them up into small bite-sized chunks. Study for half an hour. Study for an hour. Away from all distractions. You need to have time specified for study. So timetable is absolute key. You know how you can fit your time in, and that's exactly what you need to do. Have an interval, like I said. You study this much time on one thing, then you have a break and do something else, then you have a break and do something else, and likewise divide your day practically. Number two is reducing your social media. Now, we're in a time now that we need and we have social media constantly on our backs, with Facebook and WhatsApp and Twitter and YouTube and so many other things as well. They may be beneficial to a certain degree, but this time now is the time you need to put in your most effort to take maximum benefit from your exams. It means putting our WhatsApp, for example, on silent, our notifications on silent, locking off our Facebook for a couple of weeks. If we cannot live without and we cannot do, then okay, do this then. Minimum, just have a specified interval. And that ties back into our timetable, where you have a morning slot to check your messages or your social media, and then in the afternoon and in the evening, whatever works for you, you make happen. But you have to split it up and divide it equally, and then you'll hopefully, inshallah, you'll benefit. And number three is an element of spirituality. Now look, alhamdulillah, we know that you and I have to take Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as an assistant and as an aid. It is Allah who has control over all things. And if you want to succeed, you need Allah on your side. Hence I say, start off your day with Salah. Start off your day with a bit of time, maybe 5-10 minutes, not more than that, where only you and Allah, dhikrullah, dua, and you can make dua for your exams and your preparation and so on. And likewise, have a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are three practical basic things. Now some of you may say that it's very difficult, it's tough, I'm overwhelmed, I'm stressed. Listen, there is nothing that is going to last forever. Even a diamond, how is a diamond created? A masses of carbon compressed, and it withholds all that pressure until it becomes a refined diamond. What happens? You're running on a track. You're running around, and then you see someone catching up behind you. What do? Throw in the towel and accept defeat? No, you don't. You run harder and work harder, and you can see the finishing line. It is only a matter of a few weeks. Work hard. Put your priorities straight. And that is what separates the winners from the losers. Work as hard as you can, and inshallah, you will receive the result. So number one, timetable. Number two, reduce social media. And number three, bring in an element of spirituality and dua, and inshallah, you'll be successful. May Allah bring out goodness in all of us. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.